Good morning, cunts. Right, it is 10 past 9. You can't see that. It's 10 past 9. It is race day. So basically, I'm going to the races later. I'm getting my marketing midterm result in about 5 minutes. So I'm going to open that, go down to the shop, get breakfast, get changed. I'm going to show you my suit. And I have absolutely no idea where this video is going to go. I might be coming back home after the races to train. I might put in a training clip from the next day. Who knows? Okay, here we go. It's gonna be a live reaction, so. Ooh. Too clutch. 82. Midterm assessment. Nice.
Right, which tire are we saying? Not this bad boy. Not this bad boy.
Bit of an old problem. I have zero idea of a tie. Here we are though.
Ah, oh, fucking alarm, man. I'm up.
Nah, not today. Today, yeah.
When you hold me.
Right, here's what we're looking at. Probably catch you after the races. Good luck and God bless. Okay, so welcome back. Change of scenery, we are back home. Came back from the races last night. So I came home from the races at about 6:30. It was actually great crack. Like, I fucking loved it. I had great fun. And then my house, and like most people were going out of town, but I wasn't drinking obviously because I'm on Accutane, which I'll speak about later. I'll give a kind of update on how the Accutane is going. But I obviously wasn't drinking, so I was like, fuck this. I could think of a million things I'd rather do than stand in a nightclub and pretend to enjoy myself. So I'm going to bait on home. So I got the bus. And yeah, got home last night at about 10:30. So woke up after about 11 hours sleep, which is just like, oh no, 10 hours sleep, which is like, just makes the day. So breakfast this morning is going to be two of these like homemade sausage rolls. I can't remember what brand they are. They're in the fridge. But they're like, I don't know, they're fucking sick is what they are, right? And then I'm going to have 3 rashers and then probably 80 grams of cereal. So probably not the most optimal breakfast, but you know, it's going to be class, so I'm going to thoroughly enjoy it. I'm going to track everything, and I'm still going to hit my macros for the day. So that's all that bothers me. Plan for today is, I'm hoping my car is in the garage, because yeah, there's something up with the car, something up with the engine, and it should be back for today. It might not, so I don't know yet. If it is back for today, I'll get some car vlogs, well, not car vlogs, but like, I'll be going to the gym. I need to try and push today. If it's not back, I'll still probably get into the gym. I'm on push. Oh, I'm actually benching as well. Oh, that's going to be great fun. That'll be one for the YouTube video. I've absolutely no idea what weight I'm going to get. It's only my 3rd rotation benching. So yeah, that's going to be great fun. I have 2 sets on that. So, oh, yes. Like, I'm looking forward to that. Like, that just makes my day now. Now I'm fucking excited. Now I'm going to get after. And I have an exam to do as well. An online exam. So yeah, that's kind of the crack for today.
Okay, so just wrapped up the exam there. Now I'm literally just finishing it up. Like, I have all the questions done. I'm just about to hand it in. So yeah, it was grand. I'm off to the gym now soon. Just rang the car dealership or the car dealership. Who am I? Like, the fucking garage. I rang the garage, right? And they said that they're just testing it out and they're making sure that it's ready to go. So hopefully I'll be able to collect it later. If not, it'll be Monday. But look, it is what it is. Either way, I'll be making it into the gym later. So I will probably catch you for either pre-workout or in the gym.
Right, little update. So, car is back, thank God. Just literally went down there to collect it. Nice. Just making pre now, so. Intra. Not pre, I don't know why I said pre. I had a monster earlier, so I'm going to avoid pre for today. But I am going to have intra. So yeah, I'm going to make that, and I'll probably catch you in the car. Also, if my lips look like shiny, it's because I have Carmex on them, like to like stop your lips drying out. So if they look shiny, that's why. Yeah.
Episode number one of Life Hacks with Shan. Right, so basically I have to put this scooper, right, this scooper in here, and that ain't gonna fucking work.
Okay. Got this back in here, right? Maybe let it back in here. And bosh. Nice, mate. Fucking nice. Oh man, like I'm actually a fucking genius. Ugh, some bad old smell off that. The scoopity old creatine fella.
Right, catch yous in the car.
Boys, it is not looking good. So, yeah, sound gave me back the car with 30 kilometers left in her. So, fingers crossed I make it into the fucking petrol station. If not, we're in big bother. Yeah, good luck and God bless. Hopefully I won't catch you on the side of the road with me stranded. Yeah, good luck. I've just arrived at the petrol station, right? 20 kilometers left to enter. Left to fucking, till my, thingy was empty. Oh God, right. I'm gonna fill this up and then we're gonna make our way to the gym, so yeah.
Come on, let's go.
Right, we'll turn that down a little bit. Yeah, we've arrived. Car seems to be alright, so fucking happy days. Gonna go in now, stand on laterals, then we're in for a bench, so feeling good. Let's go. Also, if you fancy blowing the fucking head off yourself, go listen to this. Yeah, proper tune that.
Wednesday, November 6th. The city is underwater. The National Guard is coming. Martial law is in effect. But the criminal element never sleeps. Underneath the bridge, looting and lawlessness will be rampant in the parts of the city no one can get to. I can already see things will get worse before they get better. And some will seize the chance to grab everything they can.
We will rebuild, but not just our city. We must rebuild people's faith in our institutions, in our elected officials, in each other. Together, we will learn to believe in Gotham again.
That's all you can do. I'll get 4 next week. I didn't want to take the 1.25s, so I just took the 2.5s. But look, it's 2 reps down, but 5 kilos up, so that's what it is like.
As long as it's better than last week.
Yeah. That was a bit of a mare, if I'm being honest. Not very happy with that. Got 3, and the second rep was complete misgroove. Third rep, I thought moved quicker than the second. Or moved just as quick, so. Second rep was complete fuck up. But look,
You get that in this game.
It is what it is.
Things like this, when you fuck a set, you fuck a top set, you don't get the numbers you want. You can sit there and dwell on it, or you can just fucking put it behind you. It is what it is. Don't really do the same as anything in life. It is what it is. Take it. It's done now. Focus on the rest of the session. And don't let it affect your whole session, because you may as well walk home, frankly. Okay, a lot better. A lot better. 70 for 8. Don't know what happened that first set. Right, next exercise, seated shoulder press. Two sets here, two 5 to 8. So. Right, last warm up. Up 5 kg in total, down 2 reps, so you know what, that's all right. See, exercises like this and like high incline speed and that incline hammer strength over there, you'll have seen in previous videos, really do need a spot for, because they just get really heavy at the top. It's like when you're trying to like fully extend, it gets so heavy, man. So reps like that can be very, very handy to have a spot. So if you are training with someone, don't be afraid to ask, man. Yeah, I'm a lone ranger today, so. Right, dips. Let's see how these go. Okay, yeah, 5 moved well, so. All right, last week I got like 6 okay reps. So this week I literally want, they weren't even okay, they were bad. They were bad, but this week I want like 3-4 maybe, but really good reps. So that's what we're going for. That'll do. Okay, so next up, decline puff to fly. Luckily I go to the best gym in the southeast, so they supply the 1MR cuffs. But if you don't have some, get some. Get some. They're the fucking best in the game. I would love to say this is sponsored, but it is so not. But yeah, get yourself a set of these. Just go to the cuffs. Top set. Let's work. Okay, so there, that was a set of 11, and that rep range was 6 to 10, but I obviously went over my rep range, but that's okay, because I trained to failure. Yeah, okay, I went over by a rep, but at the end of the day, the reps do not matter that much, you know, they're only a guideline, you know, so if you miss a rep, like if you don't hit your, like if you were supposed to hit 6 to 10, and you get 5, that's okay, as long as you hit failure. I have two sets here, so I hit 11 there, and I'm going to go again, and probably get 8 to 10, around that. Good, so ignore me nearly fucking dying there, but 10 reps. The goal with all pop flies is elbows, bicep across the chest. Keep reminding yourself of that. Nobody gives a fuck how much you chest fly. Sorry to break it to you. Nobody gives a rat. Right, rest pause up. Second break. Another work again. Two tricep presses to finish off. Oof. Okay, second tricep movement. It's literally just single arm push down. When I'm choosing tricep exercises, I literally just try and pick ones that I connect well with, and then I can safely progressively work. Oh. Okay, no, I literally look invisible there. I don't know how well you can see me, but I'm gonna do a little physique update. As always, this is how I look, I guess. I guess that's what physique updates are, right? I hope no one walks in here, but look, here we are. I feel like it's very hard to keep, how do I say this? It's very hard to show the look on camera that I have in person. Now, I'm not saying I'm going to look bigger in person, but it's very hard for me to give a true look of how I look on camera. Like, I feel like you really just have to see me in person and kind of see where I'm actually at physique-wise. Like, I don't know how to get all these fucking angles. Like, I'm under, like, this is a natural light, like, this is, like, a fucking artificial light, or whatever the fuck you call them. And it's so hard for me to, like, actually give a true look on where I'm at.
Oh, this lighting is absolutely terrible. Okay, well, look, you can see me, kind of, I guess. Kind of, you can see me and you can hear me. So, I said I'd do a little update on my skin and what the crack is. So, basically, if you don't already know, I've started Roaccutane, so I got prescribed it by the dermatologist. So basically, I'm on 40 milligrams every day, so two tablets. I did a TikTok on it, if you want to go check that out. So I'm on two tablets a day. I'm currently a week in. You can't really tell, but my skin
is starting to kind of peel a small bit. Like, it feels like kind of clenched together. Like, when I come out of the shower, it feels kind of clenched together. Which is normal. It's a side effect. And then my lips are starting to dry out. So I'm just using some Carmex to kind of sort that. Aside from that, there's literally been no other side effects. I know I'm only a week in, so I don't expect there to be many. But fucking, it's working. Well, I hope it'll work. Basically, skincare wise, my skin is pretty much the same. Just a bit of a breakout on the neck. You can't really see. You can see it better on the TikTok. So if you really want to go see, you can go check that out. And then my back is kind of breaking out a small bit. Like, I've seen a few spots that weren't there from before. Aside from that, though, it's going grand. Like, any other side effects, literally there's none. I will be doing updates though in the YouTube videos and in the TikToks, so make sure you stay tuned. As always, if you did like this video, please do hit the subscribe button, like, comment, tell me what you think, tell me what you want to see, anything like that. It would really, really mean the world to me. But for now, I'll catch you in the next video.